Now, counseling is a very wonderful tool that you can really and truly reach out to souls. Souls, they don't know which way to go, they don't know the direction, they don't know where they are. They're so surrounded by wrong in their own lives. There's a lot of good there, and good will always be good, but wrong will always be wrong, bad will always be bad. And it's my job as a counselor not to tell them how bad they are or how good they are, but to tell them what's wrong in life. Because what's good doesn't need to be corrected. And what's bad can be corrected, but then you're going right into their character and their way of life and all that. And then you find that they sit back and they close up and they close their hearts, and then they don't want to go further. I've been in sessions where people start and immediately are getting that area and they shut down. They close their hearts and say, listen, I'm sorry, thank you very much, you're a wonderful man of God, but now I'm out and I'm gone. So what you need to do is to make sure that you don't let that happen to you. Now, the way to go about this is to make sure that you listen to the Spirit of God, the Spirit of the Lord, or the Holy Spirit. Because Jesus works, but he works through the Spirit, through the Spirit of the Lord, or the Holy Spirit. And sometimes even through the Spirit of Christ. Now, many people come in there. One man, Christ is the center of his life. Now, Christ is Jesus, and Jesus is the Lord. He's the Lord of all. But Christ, he's Christ-centered. Another man is the Lord-centered. Another person is Jesus-centered. Now, what I have to do is this. I have to just find out through the Holy Spirit which way the Spirit wants to work. That's in my ministry. I don't say that can be yours, but it works wonderfully, actually. And then I let the Holy Spirit take over, or the Spirit of God. Now, I do a demonstration, I'll do it now. I say to them, listen, before I start counting, I say, listen, just touch your head like this. And they usually go like this. I say, no, not like that, just like this. So they touch your head like that. I said, can you feel your fingers? Yes. Can you feel your head? Yes. I said, now that's how sensitive the Spirit of God is. So we're going to give the Spirit of God a chance today through Jesus Christ the Lord and to get into your life. But you've got to open your heart. If your heart is closed, Jesus is not going to come in. He said, behold, I stand at the door knock. If any man open the door, I will come into you. Okay, so open your heart. And I'll tell you, truthfully, if you close your heart during the session, the Lord will tell it to me and he will say, that's the end of the session. Then from then onwards, there's no more counseling. So keep your heart open. If your heart is open, all the way, you will get the full counsel of God. Because he's the full counsel of God, there's the secret counsel of God, and you need the full counsel of God today. You can come back next time. But why not get it today? If your heart is open, Jesus will give you the full counsel for this session today. Then they open their hearts. I've already had it in the past where people are sitting there, and all of a sudden the Lord says to me, the session's over. I said, why, Lord? We're not finished. No, they closed their heart. So I said to them, listen, your heart's closed. I'm afraid the session's over. No, but we're not finished yet. I said, listen, the Lord told me your heart's closed. So open your heart now before God, and God immediately will carry on. What must I do? I just say to the Lord, open my heart. And when they open the heart, the Lord carries on. It's amazing. It's a split second timing. You can't believe it. But that's how it works. Because God is, nothing's impossible to you. So, the other thing is just that you need to do is to make sure that you counsel them correctly. Don't take chances. If you take a chance with people, you remember that you're taking a chance with their souls. I must admit that in the past, you know, while I was learning, I took a chance here. Well, I tell you something, it backfires in your face. It backfires in you, and it's not easy to fix it up. It's not easy to fix it up. There's another point that I'd like to point out this, that when you're counseling people, remember this, that they are full of the devil, otherwise they wouldn't be here by you, or they're full of problems. And if they follow the devil or Satan or Lucifer, you cannot get the truth out of them. You cannot. You say, listen, God says this way, and they'll say, no, not me. My wife is, but not me. And then I say to them, well, stop a bit, let's just ask the Lord again. And the Lord says, listen, there's a devil standing away. Then I walk up to them, now I don't say you have to do it, but and I just say, devil, depart from this person in the name of Jesus. And what happens then, the way is open because the devil's gone. Yeah, but yes, brother, this is the right thing. This is truly the right thing. Right, now we're going to carry on. So you can't counsel the devil. And what happens when people come to you, the devil is going to stand in front of them. You're not going to, you'll see the person, and the person will say, listen, I need counseling, but the devil's going to come between you and them, because the devil doesn't want that person to be counseled. The devil says, no, listen, this is not the right place. This is not the right man. This is not the right time. So what you need to do is to first get rid of the devil. When he appears, in the beginning when they come, they all look like angels. You swear there's nothing wrong with them. But the moment you start going into the matter, you'll find that the devil appears. And then the devil's going to stand between you. He's going to say, no, listen, I don't want this. Not at all. But Jesus has given you authority. And he's given me authority over all the power of the enemy. He's given us authority which we use when we counsel. So remember this, use Jesus' authority. Don't come in your own authority. If you come in your own authority, you're going to go wrong. Promise you. The husband will start fighting with you, and they'll start cross-fighting across you, and then you're next to you in the middle of a real battle, and it's a battle of the flesh. Because they came to you with problems that are usually not spirit-related, they're fleshly-related. They may be spirit-related, but usually fleshly-related. The one says to the other one, listen, your mother and your did this, and your father is like this, and you, your mother, and afterwards, you get into a state of the flesh. So stay in the spirit, ask the Lord to keep them in the spirit, and then you'll find that your counsel will be a success. I want to now hand over to Peter de Villiers. He's the next one that's going to give a session on advice.